You know, there's so many different ways I fish with my buddies down south and stuff, and spider rigging, pulling cranks, vertical jigging deep brush piles and stuff like that, twitching crankbaits along the surface, and obviously the bobber or the little cork and stuff, little slip floats and stuff. So many different ways to catch crappie. But one of my favorite ways is this right here. See that right there? That's called a jig pole by B&M. This one is the ultralight. What we're gonna do is go along shorelines, brush, beaver dams, down trees, maybe docks and different things. Look for those fish that are pre-spawn. They're not spawning yet, they're pre-spawn. You know, we had a late spring here across the whole nation, the United States and all of Ontario as well. So those fish have been pushed back a little bit more with regard to water temperature, so they're not doing their business yet. But boy, when you find them, you can find some hogs and you can find some numbers. What I'm gonna use, definitely right there, crappie magnet, slab magnet, bigger body, and it just glides through with the jig. You put the jig in, it's got that thicker profile and that little spay tail that just goes back and forth, okay? Different colors and stuff. And this one, black chartreuse, okay? Real simple, everybody uses black chartreuse for almost everything they use. But I like another one, and it is the pink chartreuse. You see the common theme, chartreuse? You know it, okay? And last but not least, this one here is called the therapist, and it's got purple, and it's got some chartreuse, crazy, crazy stuff. This little thing will be the therapy of the day of catching crappie. My little therapist slab magnet. And they sit in these little containers like that. They come out perfectly clear. And just that slender little body, but beefier, you see it? It's got some beef on top there. And hopefully it attracts some of those bigger bites. But again, that little tail, and I barely move it, just like that. And it just does its business. A couple things you have to have, the power poles to stay in position, polarized eyewear to see your jig head a lot of times. A lot of times I'm not looking for fish. I'm just guessing where they are along the bush, brush and stuff, keeping it high. And all of a sudden with the glasses, polarization, you see through into the water, your jig disappears, your jig pole sets, and the battle starts. And look what I got here. I got me a sunken tree. And I got my little slab, baby. Any slabs? Whoa! Was that fast? Whoa! And we just started our day. It can't be. Could it? Really? Wow, eh? Look at that. Look at that. What a way to start. I said, doesn't matter. Rain, sun, wind. When you find the right spots, the right cadence, right presentation, right baits, little slab magnet, this is what you get right there. That's not gonna be our biggest fish of the day, but man, when you can start crappie fishing and catch a fish on the first drop, you're happy. I'm gonna put them right here. How about that, huh? Ready, crappie? Ready? Go on. That's a good eating size crappie, but boy, I came here looking for some hogs. You know those big, beautiful black and yellow ones and gold? You know what? I'm after it, man. And the watercolor, like I said, is like a tea color here. So I went to the bright chartreuse with some silver sparkle and a chartreuse head with a red and black eye. And the setup is real simple. I got the Buck's graphite jigging pole, but the ultra light. That's it. For me, this feels like an extension of my arm. It's so light and so sensitive, and it has that little hole right there in the reel seat where the blank comes through. So it's like lightning, gone. Polarized glasses, when you're fishing, brush an individual structure and cover where potentially you're only fishing below the surface. Even in tannic water like this, you gotta wear polarized glasses to see not so much the fish, but your bait disappear. Let's see if we can do that about another 20 times. Oh boy. I tell you, when you're watching the bait and all of a sudden you see a flash, your heart just stops. Oh, look at him, eh? Doing the boat rumba. You ain't big enough. But perfect size crappies, look at him. Nice back on him. But he hasn't got that big slab mouth. The ones that almost look like bass. That's the crappies we want. The ones that look like bass. Big, scary mouth. your bait straight, everything else straight, and put it back in the same spot and see what happens. Up high. I'm keeping it high, maybe 4 inches below the water. That's it. These fish are coming up and just turning on it.